Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm the old man. That right there is Phil Collins. And there's something in the air tonight. Specifically, another heart container. For level 4. I am sure that there is another heart container somewhere so that I could have the Master Sword before level 4. However, I am not going to have that because I'm not sure where it is. I don't know everything about this game. Another thing I like about this game is I've watched other LPs of this and still felt like found secret passages that I was like, oh man, I didn't know that was there. So I'm not going to quite have enough hearts to get the Master Sword before level 4, which is a little disappointing. Let's get that shield. It's a couple of other things I could have gotten before I went to level 1. I could have gotten the bracelet, but that was kind of out of the way. And something else. I could have gotten the bracelet. And where am I going? Over here, that's right. I want to go over here to this side of the coast because there is a... going up, there is a... Ah! That's supposed to block... the reason why you get that is because it blocks the fireballs, but see, just like that. But I instead was using my sword and I got hit, which is no bueno. And so that we'll get that, and then we'll go over to level 4, and then we should, after that, we should have enough to go get... Ah, poop. We should have enough to go get the Master Sword, and then we'll do that. And we'll get the Power Bracelet when we go the Master Sword, because I don't want to go through level 5 without Master Sword, because of Blue Dark Nuts. Blue Dark Nuts are, they're a pain in the butt, and I am not going to bother with that nonsense without having the Master Sword. And in level 4, they're called Vires. Hey, you little turd. Stop it. They're called Vires, but when you hit them with the white sword, they turn into two bats. Keys. Is what they're called in the manual. And, man, I've just been getting bombs like a... Whatever. Person that gets bombs. I was going to say something else, but I realized I wasn't at work. And that's usually the only place where I really use profanity is at work. And sometimes at the comic book shop, if it's warranted. Like when I'm playing Red Dragon Inn and I go and I think I've won a round of gambling. And then somebody says, I don't think so with one of those cards and then screws it over for me. That oftentimes elicits a swear from me. Otherwise, I try not to. And then at work, it's kind of like all bets are off because it's just enough to get through a day over there. All right, level 4. Let's go back. See if there's a short way. I don't have any of the things, the stairways open yet. This is another good comfort food game. Another game kind of like with Shadowgate that I just know pretty well and can kind of get through it. And, so I just play it because it's just, you know, just something that I can get through easily. I think. Though I'll probably have to get a map out for level 9 because in all my years of playing this game, I have never once been able to remember level 9. Like, ever. Just never, for whatever reason, never been able to remember level 9. I don't know why. I also don't know why I keep getting the clock after I've killed everybody. That's kind of messed up. Over here. Because there's a dock over here where level 4 is. I'm sure there is. It's over here somewhere. Love having that blue ring, boy. Man, when I was playing the random run, I was dying, and I just could not figure out why I was always dying. And I kind of realized that, oh yeah, they've got Lynels, like, right next to the starting point. That's why! Let's get the boomerang out. Certain really weak enemies, like the bits and the bats, you can kill with the boomerang. Which is good, because then you get keys. I'm up to, what, 6 keys now? Because I'm trying to play efficiently, and I wouldn't say this is a speedrun, because I am not a speedrunner, and I don't want to ever speedrun, ever. And fires. They're the sort of theme enemy for this level, and that's what they do, and they're really a pain. And do I want to go in that door? Actually, don't. After level 3, and there's some levels I don't remember as much, and level 4 is definitely one of them. Oh, compass. I don't care about compass. Yeah, the letter. I'm going to show him the letter. Hey! Hey, guys! I can buy medicine. What? I can buy medicine, see? The old man said I could. Guys, let's eat him. Chomp, chomp, chomp. And then I would be a Vyr too, because let's be honest here, those are vampires. Also, all the levels have a theme name as well. So the first one we went in was the eagle, and it was supposedly supposed to be shaped like an eagle. The other one was Moon. The other one was, I think, Manji. I don't know how you actually pronounce that. Really? Okay. And it looked like a swastika, which I think I said in the last video that... And as kids, you're always like, why is that level a swastika? And see, now you can't go up there because you need the ladder. So let's go get the ladder. And I am not entirely sure where the ladder is. And I don't know where the... I can't remember where the map is either. But as I said, I don't... For some reason, 4 and 6... and 9 are the levels that, for whatever reason, just do not stay in my brain in terms of remembering what's in them or where things are. I don't know why. 5, I know pretty well, the first 3 levels. 8, I know pretty well. But those other ones, I don't know. I don't know why I'm trying to not do that without the... Oh, the boomerang also, in case you're unaware because you've never played Zelda before, in which case, who are you and why are you watching this channel? You're kind of creeping me out. The boomerang also stuns bigger enemies. Yeah, if you haven't played, if you're a gamer and you haven't played, I don't even, like, we can't be friends. I'm sorry. It's just, I don't know. You have issues that need to be attended to. Those guys will steal my shield. That's why I'm kind of, Of course, I could just use the stinking boomerang for its intended purpose to make my life easier. And those sort of graphic-y looking those things, they are called bubbles, and what they do is take your ability to use your sword away for a little while. So that's no bueno. And I remember, the levels are pretty good about giving you an item every level until the 5th level. And I remember, as a kid, I would do the 5th level, and I was like... And I got to the thing where I thought the guy would be, and I was like, oh man, great, it's... Oh, this is good. I can, I can get the item for this level. And it turns out... It was a secret passage, and I didn't know that. And I was like, oh no! Where's the whistle? Because that was the big treasure to get. That's the thing, is there's no... I don't think there's really difficulty spikes in this one like there is in... you know, I'm just going to go ahead and pick up that map. Just for funsies. There's no big difficulty... Well, no, there is. It's level 6. I'm sorry. I misspoke. There's so a difficulty spike, and it's level 6. At the level that everybody hates. And for good reason. It's awful. I hate that level. Mostly because of Riz Robes. Because that, the... crap. The, Get... Aw. I thought I could get him in one hit. I have done that before. Somebody told me that this was... Oh, I read an article. The hands on those Manhandlers, I think is what they're called, are actually piranha plants from Super Mario Brothers. It's the same sprite. Oh, that's cool. And you can get a lot of facts about Legend of Zelda by going to legendsoflocalization.com and going on that website and looking around. It's pretty cool. Definitely recommend that you do that if you haven't ever done that. They got a lot of interesting little facts about not just Zelda, but a lot of different games. And that's where I learned that little fact that I just gave you. So you should definitely check it out if you haven't. Ah, poop. Ah! And just about to the boss of level 4, and I'm not really life-wise where I would want to be. So I might die and then ruin my no-death run. But of course, that's pretty much where any of my... Because all my Zelda runs, I want to be no-death runs. And then they end up being death runs right here. this is called the Gliok. And he is a pain in the ass. Because... And I just... As I have said, maybe I can kill him before... Nope! Can't do it. Like I said, pain in the butt. yeah, I don't think we're going to be able to do that. I almost always need medicine when I do that. I guess I could probably do better if I did a little bit fancier footwork, but I am not that skilled a player. So I just usually get some medicine and just strong arm him. But let's go get that, heart container, and then fill up our life, and then see if I can't beat... Well, that'll probably be the end of that video, and then we'll see if we can't just rush through and beat that boss. And then we'll be able to go get the magic sword in the next video and do level 5. And maybe level 6, depending on how long level 5 takes me. Shouldn't be too long, though. I know level 5 pretty good. I say. And then, yeah. Oh, what do I need? I still need arrows. I still need arrows, and I still need the food. But the food I'm not too worried about. I can get that. Where can I... That's, Ah! And the food you only need once. Yeah, I already said that. Apparently the fireballs... I don't think the fireballs can be blocked. Fireballs that the Gliok shoots can be blocked with your... shield, because clearly I was blocking them and that wasn't doing anything, so. Yeah, we'll just leave you alone to think about what you did. And don't have enough... There's arrows in here, but I can't... I don't have enough rupees to get them. So, not worried about it. And you get the silver arrow, and like I said, I don't usually... I don't typically use the... Oh my gosh, guys, come on. Bat me around like a cat and a dead mouse. I don't usually use the bow and arrows a lot for whatever reason. Not really sure. I don't really have like a reason. I just don't. I do use them on the Pole's Voice. Those enemies with the big ears that the manual tells you that you can shout at them, but you can't shout at them because the original Famicom which is basically the Japanese Nintendo, there was a microphone in the controller, and you could shout into that, and that would kill the Pole's Voice, but we don't have that, so you just have to use arrows. And the other weird thing is that even if you like could use the whistle, you can't use the whistle. Like, the whistle doesn't work. You'd think that would be the first thing you would use, because it says that I think the Pole's Voice hate loud noise, and so you would go, oh, well, I'll use a whistle. That's loud. Well, apparently it's not that loud, because it doesn't work. You have to shout in Japanese. Well, I mean, that still won't kill him, but you have to have the Japanese console, I guess is what I mean. Oh, commentary. You know what? I don't care. I don't care. I've heard worse commentary than this. I'll be one of those, don't judge me, I'm awesome, you suck. Like on American Idol. Alright, we'll walk up to the door of level 4, and then we will kill that, kill the boss of level 4, now that we've got full life. And next video, we'll do that, and then we'll get the magic sword, and then maybe do level 5 if we have time. Hopefully, I should think we would have time, but we'll see. Alright, everybody, see you next time.